Hi everyone, good morning to all of you. So it's been so long time we have interacted through online classes or YouTube classes. Whatever may be the reason, whatever may be the situation, we need to accept it and we need to move on. So according to the situation, now again we came to a platform called online classes. So far, if you consider, in offline classes, we have completed almost all the syllabus except one chapter, that is waves. So previous chapter we have studied SHM, simple harmonic motion, and now we have to study the last and final chapter, that is wave motion or waves. So there are few similarities between waves and oscillations. So what kind of similarities will be there? How can we take the benefit of SHM in understanding waves? We need to understand. So if you consider first the complete waves chapter, so what we are going to study or what we need to understand here is the very first thing. What is wave motion? What is wave motion? Or what is a wave? And how it produces? How it produces and propagates? So how a wave generates, or who is responsible for wave generation and how it propagates? Propagation means what? It moves from one place to another place. So how it travels from one place to other place, that we need to understand. Then what are the types of waves? How many types of waves are there, and based on what we divided them into, or we divide them into types? So on based on what factor we divide wave motion into types, and how many types, that also we need to understand. And what is the wave equation? Like in SHM or oscillations, we have studied like y equal to a sin omega t, or x equal to a sin omega t, or x equal to a cos omega t. That was the equation of SHM. Similarly, there is also one equation will come for wave motion. So what is the general equation for a wave motion? These are the basic things, or first things we need to understand. Then we go further and we will try to understand many things. So first, to experience or to understand the word wave, let us take few examples. Take a stone and throw it on the water surface. So there is a lake or there is something pond. You throw a stone on the water surface. Now water surface is there, and stone hit the water surface at one particular point. Then what you will see is, you will observe some circles around the point where the stone will hit the water surface. After stone hitting the water surface at one point, then you will see some circles. So it looks like circles are moving away from that point, but originally they will not move. That we will understand later. So that is called generation of wave. So when the stone hit the water surface, water molecules start oscillate or vibrate. They start vibrate. Oscillation, vibration, both are similar kind of definitions. So what is vibration? When you consider a particle, small particle, from one position, to and fro motion, or forward and back, forth, back and forth motion, or up and down motion. So from one fixed point, the particle should move to and fro motion like this. Same like oscillation what we studied earlier. So such motion we call it as vibrational motion. So when you generate vibration of the particles, then one motion will be generated through the medium. Please try to understand properly. Stone hit the surface of the water. Now water is the medium. Then water molecules are the particles of the medium and they will vibrate, and because of their vibrations a motion can be carried out along all the directions from the point of hitting. So that invisible motion we call it as wave motion. Wave motion is nothing but a kind of motion which generates due to the vibrations and which travels from one point to another point with the help of vibrations of the particles of the medium, so that it can travel from one place to another place. But we cannot see with our naked eye. So a motion which we cannot see and which can be generated from the vibration of particle, that is called wave motion. So who is responsible for wave motion? Who is responsible? Vibrations. Whose vibrations? Particles of the medium. Now you consider one more example. Take one string. Better you take like guitar string, violin string, sitar string. When you plug the string of the guitar, so it is already tightened. So when it is tight between two fixed positions, and if you plug the string, then what happens? The particles of the string start vibrate. Then wave motion will generate along the string. Or you take one string in your hand at one end, another end you hold it and give the jerk, then the other end will receive some jerk because of the wave motion. So wave will travel from this point to this point and hit that surface. Now similar way you consider, now I am speaking. So what, whoever are there near to me, surrounded in my surroundings, they can hear me. They can hear me. That is because of the sound is a kind of energy, and that is traveling from one point to another point in all the possible directions in the form of waves. Then who is helping? The medium. Like suppose I am speaking here, now you are in front of me, and between you and me there is some air. So the air molecules will vibrate, and that air molecule vibration carries the sound energy from one point to another point. So wave motion is generating from the vibrations and is carrying energy from one point to another point. So that kind of motion what we call it as wave motion. So that is the definition of wave motion. Now here that is what we are telling, what is wave motion and its production and propagation. How it propagates? With the help of medium, with the help of vibrations. So that's why when there is a source which can vibrate and which can generate wave, then that can travel. So that kind of motion which is not visible to our naked eye, that is called wave motion. Now the next thing, when you consider such wave motion, as I said, how many types of waves are existing? So when you consider any wave motion, like as I said, sound is traveling from one point to another point. Sound is one kind of wave motion. Light travels from one point to another point. Like sunlight traveling from sun to various parts of the universe. So based on all those waves, when you consider all waves together, you can categorize them, you can divide them into two types mainly. And what are those is? One is mechanical waves. and another one is non-mechanical waves. One is mechanical waves, another one is non-mechanical waves. Now question arises, on what basis we divided the waves into two types, like how we call them as mechanical and how we can call them as non-mechanical, or when we call them as mechanical or non-mechanical. So when you consider waves, we are telling that vibrations needed and all. See, sometimes when you consider a wave, that wave does not require any medium to propagate from one point to another point. Without help of any medium also, wave can travel from one point to another point. But there are few waves which always require a medium to travel from one point to another point. So the two best examples are, one is sound wave, another one is light wave. So let us consider first sound wave. So sound wave is the well-known wave which we can produce with the help of our vocal cords. So when that sound wave generates, that requires always medium. It can travel through air, gas medium. It can travel through iron or any solid material. It can travel through water also. You go inside the swimming pool and speak, something will come like that. But sound will come out. So sound will travel through the water. Sound can travel through solid. Sound can travel through air. In the classroom, when I spoke, when I am teaching, you all are able to listen to me. That is because of what? What was there between you and me? What medium was present? Air medium. So that's why the waves which require medium for their propagation. Propagation means to travel from one point to another point. That wave we call it as mechanical wave. And the best example for that is sound waves. And that is what one part we will study in this chapter. Sound waves, related to sound waves. Also we call them as longitudinal waves. Again, what is this longitudinal waves? We will understand that also. But right now you just remember that one is mechanical wave. That is the best example for that is sound wave. Similar way when you consider non-mechanical wave. And the best example is, that is light. Light, sunlight. When you consider the initial region of the sun, means between sun and earth, if you consider the initial region near to sun, there is a region called completely empty. No air, no medium, nothing. What we call it as? Vacuum or free space. Even though there is no medium, there is nothing, completely empty, free space, vacuum. Still, the light is traveling from sun to the earth. That means the light can travel without help of medium in the form of wave. And such kind of waves, we call it as non-mechanical waves. That is light. But we will not study this light part in this one. We study that as separate topic in second PUC, in second year syllabus, ray optics and wave optics. That is completely about study of light, non-mechanical wave. But we also study one more thing in this chapter, that is waves on string. Waves on string. Both are the sound wave as well as waves on string. Both are mechanical waves only. So what is that? As I said, if you take guitar string, if you pluck it, any stretched string, if you pluck it, then vibrations will generate and that will generate one kind of motion along the length of the string. That wave we call it as waves on string. And that's why we call it as waves on string. Waves on string. See, both we are telling mechanical waves. But there is again difference. This we call it as longitudinal.
and this we call it as transverse. One is longitudinal and another one is transverse. So one wave we will study in this chapter is sound, nothing but longitudinal wave. Another wave we will study is transverse wave, whose example we take it as waves on string. First you consider sound. Sound means whatever I am speaking, whatever you speak, whatever when two objects hits will come out. So, horn of vehicle. So like that, all are called what? Sound waves. They travel in air, they travel in solid, they travel in liquid. And those all waves when you consider, we call them as longitudinal. But now the question will come here. What is that question? Sound is always longitudinal or not? That is the question we should get clarification. We need to get clarification. Now, before that, we need to understand what is longitudinal, what is transverse first. So let us try to understand the definition of longitudinal and transverse. See here. When there is some medium, this is one particular medium. Now wave is traveling through the medium. Whether it is longitudinal wave or transverse wave, we don't know. So this is the wave propagation. And always remember that wave always travels in straight line. In the 9th class or lower classes, you might have studied like this is the wave representation. But that doesn't mean that wave is traveling like this. This is the representation of displacement, which we have represented same like in SHM's chapter. In case of SHM, how we represented the displacement of the particle, same way we represent here also. Why? We will understand in further definitely. But most of the students have misconception that this is the actually wave is traveling like. No, the wave is not traveling in this manner. The wave always travels in straight line manner. The wave travels along the line. But as the wave is traveling through a medium, there is one possibility that the particles of the medium, suppose here one particle is there, 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 they may vibrate parallel to the propagation like this, like this, like this. So started here, went like this, like this, like this, same like SHM. But here we are calling it as vibration. So here, every particle of the medium through which wave is traveling, all those particles will vibrate along the line which is parallel to the propagation of wave. So always the particles of the medium vibrate along the line parallel to the wave propagation, along the wave motion. Then such wave, what we call it as longitudinal wave. So longitudinal wave means what is the condition we can write? So the simple condition is direction of propagation. Propagation is parallel to the line along which particles vibrate. Particles of the medium vibrate. So such kind of wave, what we call it as longitudinal wave. Now same way, if you take these particles, if they vibrate like this, means going up, coming down, going down, then coming up. So about this point, if it is vibrating like this everywhere, every particle, how they are vibrating? The direction of propagation is perpendicular to the line of vibration. If particles are vibrating along the direction perpendicular to the direction of propagation,
then such kind of wave motion we call it as transverse wave. If this vibration was parallel to this line, direction of propagation, then longitudinal. If this direction of vibration is perpendicular, then we are telling what? Transverse wave. So here what condition will come? Direction of propagation is perpendicular to the line along which particles vibrate. So parallel means longitudinal wave. Perpendicular means transverse wave. What should be perpendicular? What should be parallel? Direction of propagation and line along which particles will vibrate. They may be parallel, they may be perpendicular. Based on that, we divide them into two types. First, based on the medium required, two types. Mechanical, non-mechanical. Mechanical means requires medium. Non-mechanical means does not require medium. And here, based on the vibration of the particles, mechanical waves again divided into two types. One is longitudinal and another one is transverse. Suppose, one question I asked earlier, sound wave is always longitudinal or it can be transverse? If you think in that manner, take one iron rod. Now with a hammer, you hit like this. So when you hit like this, the vibrations will be like this. But sound also travels along the same direction from this end to this end. So the vibration and the propagation both are parallel. Then sound wave in this iron rod is longitudinal. But same rod you consider and hit like this. Like this. So they will vibrate perpendicular directions. But that doesn't mean that sound will go up and down. Sound will travel from one end to other end only. So in this situation, direction of vibration parallel to direction of propagation. That's why in this situation, the sound wave is longitudinal. But here, as you are giving vibrations in perpendicular direction, here in this situation, the sound wave can be transverse. So sound wave can be longitudinal, sound wave can be transverse. But that is in case of what medium? Here iron rod means what? Solid material. Through solid material, the sound wave can be longitudinal or otherwise transverse. But when you consider the sound wave in air, when I am speaking, when someone is making noise in the air, region, space, then sound travels always in the form of longitudinal wave. Because the air is free, that can vibrate only along the propagation. That's why the air molecules always propagate along the direction of propagation. So both are parallel. That's why sound wave is longitudinal always in air medium. But it can be longitudinal or it can be transverse in case of solids. Right? So now, but here we will not study the solids case. In this chapter we study about sound in air only. Sound in air. That is nothing but longitudinal waves only. One is longitudinal waves. Then another one is waves on string. This is transverse. What is this? When there is a string tight and if you plug the string at any point, then it will start vibrating. Like just one simple example if you consider. If you give jerk here like this, up and down like this. So the string particles will vibrate like this. But the wave is traveling from here to here. So wave is traveling along horizontal. But the string particles will vibrate up and down. That's why what kind of wave we can call it as transverse wave. So one is sound waves in air, longitudinal we will study. Another one is waves on the stretched string, nothing but transverse waves. These are the two things we are going to study in this chapter. So what exactly we will study in this chapter is first thing, whether it is longitudinal wave or transverse wave. What is the general representation of wave equation and how we represent, why we represent in that manner, and what are all the parameters associated with it? Because the very first kind of question in the entrance which can come from this chapter is based on wave equation, general wave equation. So what is the general wave equation is y equal to a sin omega t minus r plus kx. So it is somewhat looking like SHM equation, but kx, some new quantities also came. We need to understand with the help of SHM equation how we are, why we are representing like this wave equation, and what are all the parameters associated with this equation, and what kind of questions we may get in the entrance based on this equation. Then we will understand what is the speed of wave, sound wave, or better to say longitudinal wave, in solids, in liquids, in gas. Also we study what is the wave, transverse wave speed, nothing but waves on string. So what is the speed of longitudinal wave in solid, liquid, gas, as well as what is the speed of transverse waves in string. Then we study about superposition. If two waves mix each other, what will happen? Then we study about beats concept. Then we study about stationary waves. So what are all those things we will study one by one. So today's conclusion is all about the basic knowledge about the wave. What is wave? What is vibration? What is wave motion? What are all the types of there? How it propagates? With what help it will propagate? Who will produce it? And what are the types? And on what basis we divided them? And what are the types of there in mechanical waves? And what is the general equation? Just we took the equation. So these all things, basic things we required. So you have to define all the things in your notebook clearly. What is vibration? What is wave motion? And what are the types? What is mechanical wave? What is non-mechanical wave? What is longitudinal wave? What is transverse wave? And all those things. Right? So tomorrow or in the coming class, we will take this equation and we will also understand why this equation came or how this equation has come to represent the wave motion, and also what are all the types of questions will come based on this equation. Thank you.